Royal author Andrew Morton, who has recently updated his unauthorized biography on Meghan, has claimed the palace did not sit on its hands while she was a full-time working royal. Rather, he said, the palace supported the Duchess of Sussex, either by defending her from online trolls or by denying certain reports. And a palace insider agreed on this take, telling the Mail on Sunday aides had bent over backwards to help Meghan. Mr. Morton, who gained worldwide fame with his biography of Princess Diana in 1992, added 6 new chapters to his book Meghan, A Hollywood Princess, which includes new claims on what happened behind palace doors during the months the Duchess of Sussex was a working royal and her relationship with other members of the royal family. Speaking about the support offered to Meghan by the palace, he said, from time to time it did formally dispute stories, such as one suggesting that Kate had slapped down Meghan for being rude to one of her staff. This never happened, said the palace. Moreover, Kensington Palace spent hundreds of hours monitoring social media posts. It unveiled a code of conduct for internet interactions on the royal family's platforms. Violent threats were reported to the police, and sexist and racist comments deleted. Express.co.uk has contacted representatives for the Duchess of Sussex for comment. When contacted by Express.co.uk, Kensington Palace declined to comment. A royal source insisted the family had done all it could to support Meghan. A source had claimed in early 2019 palace staff was spending a lot of hours reviewing social media comments addressed to the Duchess of Sussex and the Duchess of Cambridge, also a victim of a barrage of vile online remarks and threats. Meghan opened up on feeling let down by the palace in her landmark interview with Oprah Winfrey, first broadcasted in March. During the 2-hour-long program, the Duchess said reports first emerged in November 2018 she had made Kate cry in the run-up to her nuptials were false, adding the reverse happened. Speaking to Ms. Winfrey, she said, "What was hard to get over was being blamed for something that not only I didn't do but that happened to me. And the people who were part of our wedding going to our comms team and saying, I know this didn't happen. I don't have to tell them what actually happened, but I can at least go on the record and say she didn't make her cry. And they were all told the same." She went on claiming everyone in the institution knew it wasn't true she had made Kate cry, but the palace never took the step to negate the story. Meghan also told Ms. Winfrey she was not being protected by the institution. Rather, she added, they were willing to lie to protect other members of the family, but they weren't willing to tell the truth to protect me and my husband. Prince Harry, who joined Meghan at a later stage of the interview, told Ms. Winfrey they decided to step down as senior royals due to a lack of support and lack of understanding. In the wake of the Sussex's bombshell claims, Buckingham Palace released only one statement in which it said the whole family was saddened to learn the full extent of how challenging the last few years have been for Harry and Meghan. It added, the issues raised, particularly that of race, are concerning. While some recollections may vary, they are taken very seriously and will be addressed by the family privately. Harry, Meghan and Archie will always be much loved family members. Prince Harry and Meghan officially stepped down as full-time working royals at the end of March 2020. They have since established their lives in California, where they live with their 2 children, Lilibet Diana and Archie Harrison.